Great. How's your coffee?
It's pretty awesome.
Great.
We got some more questions to answer.
All right. Put away the banjo.
All right. Little banjo later.
Later.
So hi, I'm Brian Fitzpatrick and I go by Fitz.
I'm Ben Collins Sussman and I go by Ben Collins Sussman.
And we're here to answer a few more questions today. I've got the first question right here on my G-pad.
Ah.
You know, the battery life on this thing is fabulous.
It's great visibility outside,
yeah?
too.
Yeah, excellent. It works really well in low light conditions. Mm. So the first question is, how difficult is the interview process currently? I've heard horror stories of as many as 7 interviews spanning 9 months, which is a long period of uncertainty.
No, sounds like a lot of, you know, there are a lot of urban legends, right? I mean, I think it is possible that may have happened to somebody at some point, but I think it's an extreme outlying case, so of course that's what spreads around the net. It's certainly not the norm.
Wait, there's always going to be the one person that made it through in 3 weeks, and then the one person took 9 weeks.
Right, so let's talk about the center of the bell curve.
Right, the center of the curve.
What's the center of the curve? You usually get a phone interview or two within a week or two.
Right.
Right, and then if you do well, then you go on site, and you do a few interviews in one day.
Correct.
And then, you know, a week or two later, you hear back. That's the typical
process. And sometimes
there
might be a follow-up interview to ask a few more questions,
but
that sort of thing.
That's the standard, what most people experience.
Right. I mean, we've done a lot of research as to how many interviews are the optimal number. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure what that is, but I know that we've tried fewer interviews and more interviews as well.
We know that, you know, we don't just keep throwing people through interviews over and over and over, hoping that they'll get better or something will change. It's like, it's a very deliberate process.
But the point is... The point is to evaluate people to see if they're good for Google in the long term, not if it's just here to fill an immediate short-term need.
Right. In fact, you know, that's a fallacy we've talked about before in other talks, right, where sometimes a company will say, oh, we need somebody, let's interview 20 people and hire the best 3 no matter what.
Right.
And Google absolutely doesn't do that. Google says, look, do we want this person in general for a long time, regardless of, you know, whether we need them at this moment or not.
So, well, it's important to find a match to make sure not only that the person we're interviewing is a match for the company, but that we're a match for them as well, right? Mm-hmm. So it's a sort of a two-way street. I don't know. I think that's it for that question.
I think that's it for that question.
All right.
What's the next question?
We'll be back later.
Oh, we'll be back. Okay. Bye-bye.